These men get down with the blues on CSN. It takes two to tango. CSN presents the NHL and Caps hockey. This evening, the boys with the blue notes on their sweaters have arrived in Washington, where the Capitals eagerly anticipate a Saturday jam session. These youngsters definitely have their hearts in the right place, roaring for the Caps, who won't have the real Oshie this evening, but will have Tom Wilson in good spirits back home. A very pleasant welcome to you alongside Craig Lachlan. I'm Joe Beninati. We'll make way for Al Koken very soon. When you think about it, the Caps and the Blues should present a very attractive matchup. Why is that in your eyes?
It's very intriguing to me because both teams play a very similar style. Both coaches demand details, discipline, and hard work. I really make this out to be a heavyweight matchup in the National Hockey League, Joe B. Let's get ready to rumble here tonight.
Last summer, Braden Holtby was presented with a five-year, $30 million contract. In the last 6 months, he's showed why he's worth every penny.
Yeah, he's been amazing. 37 wins his last 48 starts. He leads the NHL in wins overall and wins on home ice. The superlatives stay the same. Wow, what a save. Great play by Holtby. Unbelievable glove. But it's his quickness, his lateral movement, his anticipation. He is having a season of the ages.
He won't be in there tonight, but when we check the Toyota League leaders, 45 wins, he's breathing rarefied air.
Right now, sixth goalie now in history to record 45 wins in a season, and he took the least amount of games to get it. He joins Brodeur, the only one to do it twice, Bernie Parent in the 70s, Luongo, Nabokov, and Kiprusoff make this impressive list.
Folks, last night, John Carlson was the overtime game-winning hero. Not bad for your first game back from injury. When we return, more discussion of his impact on and Detroit Brouwer. As the Capitals want to see the Blues off-key tonight, Locker, the ISOCAMs delivered by Fitzmall.com. It's focused on the powerful deliveries of John Carlson this season.
Yeah, welcome back, John. He missed 25 games this season, but he's raring to go the last 10 games to get this Caps team going in the playoffs. Obviously, he's a rusher more so than a crusher. He joins the attack. Timing is imperative to any defenseman sneaking in, and John anticipates as well as anybody. Last night, got his first OT winner of his career on a nice-looking slap shot.
He said he wasn't going to shoot that one. Throughout Caps history, this team's been known for high-scoring right-handed D-men.
Yeah, Hatcher the leader by quite a wide margin in goals and points. Mike Green, Murphy, Cote, and there's John Carlson that sits fifth in goals and points. Big names on the Capitals' blue line over the years.
Here we go. John's going to pay special attention to Vladimir Tarasenko, a stick-handling maestro who keeps the tempo snappy for the Blues. St. Louis hopes their star Russian can keep up with his DC comrades. Next on CSN. It's almost playoff time. This is the NHL on CSN inside of Verizon Center for regular season game number 74. Alex Ovechkin and the Capitals welcoming the St. Louis Blues. Vladimir Tarasenko in town. First of two meetings between these two. They'll do it again on April 9th. As we are off and running with Washington in the throwback sweaters, the home ice reds. Williams has room here, but this is offside against Washington, 9 seconds in.
Yeah, good start there in the neutral zone for the Capitals, trying to get past their D. Edmondson. He stood up, which threw everything offsides. There's a look at Troy Brouwer, sporting the new uni of the St. Louis Blues. That deal for TJ Oshie, he's having a real good season with 33 points.
Points in three consecutive games for Brouwer, the former Cap, now at 30 years of age. Dmitry Orlov in a foot race, going to get there ahead of a hard-charging Robbie Fabry. Orlov plays it on for Justin Williams. The Caps are minus TJ Oshie again. You could tell the top of the screen as the line combinations and deep pairings pass before your eyes. Snapshot from the angle. Jake Allen in the cage for St. Louis, with his initial stop of the contest. Philip Grubauer at the other end of the rink as Ovechkin puts the head fake on, sends it through a seam. Snap pass to the front that came right through the paint. Alsner defended there by Stastny, and revving it back up the other way comes Schwartz. Jaden Schwartz, the 23-year-old from Saskatchewan, as Carl Alsner will play for Washington, bottled up in the corner.
And they're going to be bottled up a lot because that's what St. Louis's game is all about, getting their big, heavy bodies on the forecheck. Caps D are going to have to be efficient tonight with short, crisp passes, more so on the tape than rimming them around the wall.
Burakovsky, Kuznetsov, and Johansson out there now for D.C. No score in this one into the second minute of the opening period. Shattenkirk moves it ahead, and he loves to get up into the flow. 22 in white, a high-scoring defender.
Well, Shattenkirk, you look at Petrangelo, all those guys join the attack. Shattenkirk, 39 points.
Grubauer with a good stop there on a backpedaling Shattenkirk as Johansson will scale it in. Barry Trotz wants to make a line change. Outstanding rookie defender, the towering Colton Parayko, has the puck.
Not bad when you're 6'6 and over 225 pounds.
He's the next one in the line of outstanding defenders for the Blues year after year. Backus down low for Berglund. Grubauer ready with a blocker pad. 5-on-5 play continues. Bortuzzo towards the front. And that's knocked aside by the Caps reserve netminder, spelling Braden Holtby tonight. Chimera creamed along the boards by Bortuzzo. Beagle gets involved. And he is roughed up. This is a St. Louis team year after year that loves to throw its weight around. Centering pass deflected right on. Allen makes a stop there on Wilson at the top of the paint. You see them work along the boards. It's Orpik at point position, a long wrister that floats wide as Allen was heavily screened. Wilson covering up from the point, a wrister that's knocked away by Robert Bortuzzo.
That's a thing they do a lot. Four defensemen for the St. Louis Blues have 100 or more blocked shots. They really help their goaltenders. On the Capitals side, three different D have over 100 blocks.
Edmondson with a long wrister. Follow-up chance denied there by Grubauer as Brodziak was dangerous. Kyle Brodziak had a shorthanded goal last night in a win over Vancouver on home ice at Scott Trade Center. Blues go into the cycle. Brodziak collared by Orpik. Long drive that was muffled. Grubauer paddles it to the side dasher. Dmitry Orlov galloping out of his own zone. Orlov accelerates through neutral. Dmitry Orlov at the top of the rush as he was met by Edmondson. It's a turnover. Back come the Blues.
At the other end, Upshaw was railed into the wall right at the Zamboni entrance. Lost his lid, slow to the bench for the St. Louis Blues.
Daniel Winnick looking wide for Williams. Allen will get involved, plays it off the boards. Mike Richards out there for Washington. The Caps in the middle of a change. Williams' pass, intended for Carlson, plucked by Petrangelo. Back come the Blues. No score in this one, just about 4 minutes gone by in the opening period. Brouwer wipes out. Alex Ovechkin on a take back, and working through center, it's Williams. Three abreast of the attacking line. Ovechkin's the trailer to his backhand. That was blocked by Parayko. Nicholas Backstrom, then Ovechkin. One more for Williams, shadowed by Shattenkirk. Williams turns the corner, fires! Allen got a glove on that. Niskanen well in from point position for Williams once more. Bumped by Shattenkirk. Williams up close and personal, spins off the dasher. Ovechkin helps, tees it up for an Alsner wrister. An easy stick save for Jake Allen. Williams shimmies loose. Shattenkirk put the arm bar on him, and the Blues will counterpunch through center. Brouwer on the feed looking for Stastny. Down low! Beaten by Grubauer.
That's a great save to start for Groby. Closed up that five hole. Stastny trying to put it between the wickets. Excellent pass, by the way, springing. Stastny was Troy Brouwer.
Paul Stastny, the third leading point producer for these Blues. St. Louis coming in 44 wins and 97 points overall. Tied for the top spot in the Central Division.
And their numbers overall just about equal when you look at their home record versus their road record.
Kuznetsov digging in with Laterra. Point drive, Orlov on a slap pass. Looking for Johansson. He just touched it wide of the net.
Wide open net, had the goalie frozen in his skates, Joe. Just couldn't hit that empty twine.
Orlov really loves that slap pass. So does this man. Kuznetsov to the goal mouth. Off the netminder, Allen. One more chance, and it's snapped out of the air. by the reflexive netminder in the cage for the Blues.
The goaltenders have been tested here early on at Verizon Center. The matchup of the heavyweights, one from the east, one from the west. Troy Brouwer misses on his first attempt. The second one gets through to Stastny going into the goaltender. And then another play by Orlov. Here's that slap pass looking for Mojo, and it's wide open. He had frozen the defenseman, frozen the goaltender. Real good look for Marcus. I'd love to see him get on the scoreboard. He's got no goals, Joe, his last 12 games. He's skating. He's been playing fast. I'd like to see him get some confidence scoring goals.
Berglund and Yashkin Locker going two on two the other way here for the Blues. No score in this one, approaching the 6-minute mark of the first as Wilson dumps it in. Allen is very aggressive around that goal crease. Schmidt's wrister turned away by Berglund as the Capitals are delayed offside. Shots on goal are 5-4. Favor St. Louis. Backes moves it ahead. On the run, it's Yashkin. John Carlson right there with him. Schmidt gets involved for the Capitals. To an open Richards, and he'll deflect back to neutral ice. St. Louis coming into tonight's matchup. Already qualified for postseason play. They've done that in each of their last five seasons. Washington, a point of any kind tonight would clinch the President's Trophy. Shattenkirk just missed as a seam opened up for him. They work the cycle play. Carlson gets in the way for Washington. Well done there defensively. Pareko keeps it in a point position. Turnaround drive, Brodziak denied. And then Schwartz's rebound was turned aside just the same. Caps have it on the run. Winnick. Angling in, one hand on his blade, spins one for the trailer. Richards never received that pass. Brodziak was in the way.
Very good communication coming back. Pareko came back and helped out his other partner, showed good speed coming back. He was directing traffic all the time from center ice down to the top of the circle, and he got Winnick going on his backhand.
TJ Oshie sitting this one out. The plan is for him, at least it was earlier this afternoon, to skate on his own tomorrow. Dealing with those flu-like symptoms. As Williams sets up shop, he has a defense hung up. Williams flushed out by Stastny. Ovechkin's wrister is blocked by Bortuzzo. Caps working the cycle. An interior pass from Backstrom didn't find Ovechkin as the Blues work through center. Brouwer full speed ahead on the crisscross with Fabry. Those two get their signals crossed. Ovechkin will go in the other direction. Alex Ovechkin works wide. This is offside against the Capitals. 7 minutes, 58 seconds in. Blues and Caps. We expect this to be a real good one. On CSN on his return as the Blues are in town tonight with the NHL on CSN. Locker Star Tracks presented by Toyota. Let's play keep away. I'll take these two and so would Troy.
Yeah, two really good go-to guys. Tarasenko, he leads the team in goals and points. And he can dangle with the best of them, all skating and stick skills on the Capitals side. Kuznetsov, 36 points his last 32. He leads the Caps when it comes to points with 73 and assists. His assists are third most in the NHL. These guys are former teammates all the way back to the World Juniors in 2011.
I'm not sure if they have enough skill. Just a little deprived in that area. They are both wizards. Tarasenko showing off his handle right now. They jam for it along the boards. Kuznetsov covering up on Schwartz, who breaks loose. Looks for the late guy, the wrister that's snapped wide by Joel Edmondson, a 22-year-old Manitoba native. Schwartz off the head fake. Swivels around Alsner. Centering pass blocked by Grubauer. Edmondson fires, just missed the mark. He scored his first NHL goal last night. He apparently likes the taste of it. Coming right back looking for more tonight.
Yeah, he's joining the rush. He's learning quickly. Part of that schemes now among all NHL teams.
Johansson on the dump in. Edmondson to play. He's teamed up with Alex Pietrangelo, one of the finest young defenders in the NHL. I say young, he's at 26 already. He's played five seasons. Schmidt there. With help from his partner, John Carlson. Berglund rolls it down low. great size throughout this St. Louis lineup.
Yeah, very similar to the Caps and how they built their teams. You look at their goaltenders, Elliott's been terrific, Holtby terrific. Their blue line is very mobile and big, much like the Caps. And they've got star power too. You know, we don't see them often. This is the first time we'll see them, and we'll see them in a couple of weeks to finish off the season on the road in St. Louis.
10:25 left in this one, first period. Locker, Wilson on the go. Snapshot that was deadened by Shattenkirk. Centering pass off the netminder, Allen. Blues without Jay Bouwmeester, one of their finer defenders, as well as Carl Gunnarsson tonight. And don't forget Alex Steen, one of their sharpshooters across the top.
Starting to skate is Steen. A lot of stuff on his own, trying to get ready if he can come back prior to the playoffs.
The St. Louis team, on the whole, more than 250 man games lost to injury this season, and yet still 44-22-9. At the line, this is going to be whistled down for an offside against St. Louis. Chance for us to step away. We've crossed the midway mark. Stan Galiev and the boys back on home ice at Verizon Center.
Here with Todd Reirden. Todd, this late in the season, first look at the St. Louis Blues. How do you go against a team you haven't seen?
Yeah, a little bit of preparation the last few games, and they've been real hot. Three straight shutouts in a row, so real big challenge for us tonight. Bigger team that plays a physical style of hockey, and like I said, it's a good challenge for us here.
All right, we appreciate Todd Reirden and Illegal Seafood's Bite of the Night.
Al, those three consecutive shutouts, of which Todd was speaking, were all authored by Brian Elliott. Brian didn't even make the trip to D.C. this evening for this clash. Jake Allen, who is his understudy and who filled in beautifully for him while Elliott was injured earlier this season, has actually appeared in more games than Elliott. A long drive from Brodziak that's deflected into the end zone, safety netting.
On that play inside the blue line, Richards was nicked up top as Hitchcock looks on. Lucky his team did not go shorthanded. The big question with Hitchcock, is he going to get some success in the playoffs? There's Richards shaking his head, very unhappy. But Ken Hitchcock, always great numbers in the regular season. Can he pull through in the postseason? That's the big question mark. They've been pushed out early on in series. This season, they've got to go farther, I think, for his hockey club.
Last year, 51 wins, 109 points. They won the Central. They were second best in the West, and they got dumped in the first round by Minnesota in six. It necessitated some changes, including seeing T.J. Oshie exchanged from St. Louis to his new home here in Washington. No Oshie tonight. No, that has to be a sore spot. T.J. wanted to face his old mates. He'll get a chance on April 9th in the Gateway City as Troy Brouwer scoops it in. Brouwer, netminding prospect Phoenix Copley, were involved in that deal going back towards St. Louis from Washington. Justin Williams, who was a free agent acquisition, both he and Oshie playing important roles in what has been a fabulous season for Washington as Backstrom gets the attacking line. Hits Ovechkin for the snapshot, blocked by Edmondson. Backstrom resurfacing. Niskanen switch it up. Alsner's wristers deflected by Robbie Fabry. Backstrom maneuvers out of the corner. Double team. Throws one to the front. Backhand! Jake Allen makes the save on Ovechkin as the Blues clear.
That was a real good play. Number one, the pass. Number two, Ovechkin getting away from Pietrangelo, who had pretty good position but didn't realize how quick Ovi was to get a stick down.
Tarasenko looking for Schwartz. That wrister blocked by Alsner. And Burakovsky sets sail for Washington. Andre Burakovsky, three-on-three. Poke check there rather smoothly by Schwartz. On the attack come the Blues. Laterra back for Shattenkirk. A wrister on the way that's denied in front of Philip Grubauer. Grubauer called on for seven stops so far. Tarasenko, sneaky little twister pass from him, a la Kuznetsov.
That was on his backhand. That was hard to administer when he's that low behind the net at the far post.
Parayko makes the takeaway from Burakovsky. On the money for Tarasenko. Then Laterra will switch sides. It's blocked off of Yashkin's blade and out of play. Your Virginia Lottery RoboCam replay looks like this.
And a real nice pass from Nick Backstrom. Watch him shield the puck, getting away from the D. Ovechkin set up with Pietrangelo in front of the net. Notice that little shove with the left side of his body. Sort of knocks Pietrangelo off kilter. OV with the best chance in the first period.
Alex had a couple of goals at the Blues' expense last season. Both he and Backstrom have terrific career numbers against St. Louis, albeit in limited duty.
Yeah, for Ovechkin, 17 points, Joe B, in 11 games. He's done real well.
Send away, just a bit strong. Allen gets out of the cage to beat Chimera to it. Backus using the dasher to start the kickback for the Blues. Orpik right there waiting for Berglund, and he'll funnel back to rewind.
That is an awesome play by Orpik. 3-on-2, and he stands up at the blue line, Joe. Doesn't give him any time to enter and makes it look easy. That's a sign of a veteran D, taking away that gap, closing it down, and giving Backus absolutely no running room.
Beagle working after Edmondson as time ticks away in this opening period. It's the NHL on CSN, along with Craig Lachlan and Al Koken. I'm Joe Beninati. So glad you've tuned in. No score on the board. That was the story last night. The Caps and Devils played 0-0 through 60 minutes. Washington eventually winning on a John Carlson blast. Carlson becoming the first Caps defender in franchise history to win a 1-0 overtime game with a goal. Galiev turns. Galiev feeds it up top. Carlson's bid was blocked. Straight ahead come the Blues. It'll get away from Brodziak as Schmidt is there to fish it away for Washington. Ow, an awkward misstep, but 88 bounces right back to his feet.
Yeah, toe pick and his stick landed underneath them. That looked uncomfortable for Schmidty.
Fabry goes indirect for a Brouwer dump in. Troy Brouwer in hot pursuit. Schmidt along the wall, so to Parayko as the Caps will clear. Williams goes stride for stride with Shattenkirk. The trailer is winning. Blues in the visiting white sweaters. Williams looking cross rink. Fabry should dig it out. Colton Parayko, 3 years, University of Alaska. Two times an All-American. Towering youngster, banks it ahead for Stastny.
Like that big fella Schuster that came out of college. Very similar.
Plays down in Tampa.
Yeah.
Schuster's even taller.
And they'll need more of him with Stroman being done for the season in the playoffs, Joe.
Such a significant blow to the Tampa Bay Lightning. As Kuznetsov works, spins and twists for Ovechkin. He'll wrap the corner, feed it up top. Kuznetsov dancing. Look at this on the back pedal. Edmondson was in the lane.
Hey, he had a chance to shoot there, Joe. Still, I mentioned it last night. Going to be shooting the puck a little more than looking for that pass.
Johansson turns. Feeds it for an Ovechkin drive that goes wide of Allen. Kuznetsov bats the rebound out of the air to feed the slot. Not bad. An aerial pass followed about, 20 seconds earlier by at least 8 backwards crossovers. Orlov in for Johansson. Tap, tap on the passing. Orlov fires. He missed it high. Johansson gets topside, feeds to the slot. Kuznetsov fanned on it. There's a penalty call coming. It's against St. Louis. It's going to be a hook. When you return, the Capitals will have the first power play on the night. No score in D.C. on CSN. Minutes, he's in the penalty box again. No score, Caps and Blues tonight. Our Nissan road to the playoffs, checking out the Western Conference.
Yeah, Dallas, St. Louis, and Los Angeles, and Anaheim have clinched. I think Chicago's in, San Jose's in. The matchup, Nashville will be in. It's Minnesota and Colorado, and a huge win for Minnesota today. 4-0. In Denver, Joe, to move 5 points ahead. It's going to be a tough road ahead for Colorado. Their schedule, one of the toughest, with about a half a dozen games left.
Including a meeting with the Caps at Pepsi Center in Denver in early April. Washington's man advantage, second best power play on the circuit at 23%. Penalty killers for the Blues are third overall. Williams attacked by Pietrangelo. Johansson plays it to the point. Niskanen. Midpoint, blocked away, and cleared by Upshaw. Scotty Upshaw dancing with it and places the puck deep so that Ken Hitchcock can change his penalty killers. Niskanen for Washington, driving right back. Matt Niskanen with 3.5 to go in the first period. Swoops into the attacking territory. Niskanen chops one towards the cage. Blues have that surrounded, and It's an easy clear for Shattenkirk.
That's a pretty good penalty-killing team, this St. Louis Blues Club. They get a lot of practice. They take a lot of minor penalties. Capitals' power play have to execute now, Joe. It's against a good top unit. Execution, the quick passes can break the Blues down.
Capitals just 3 for their last 23 overall with a man advantage.
And that's unlike the Caps. That's about 13%. They're operating at over 20% now as one of the best in the NHL.
50 seconds in the power play. Kuznetsov turns wide. Slings it back to Ovechkin. Alex offers for Carlson. Brushed it to the outside. Chimera below the goal line. Kuznetsov for a Carlson faked one-timer. Kuznetsov looking for the snap pass, deflected, and away comes Brodziak, 2-on-2. Caught there from the blind side, Burakovsky will rev it back up. Kuznetsov on the entry. Yevgeny Kuznetsov feeds, Carlson fires, woo, that got up high on Allen. He made the shoulder stop.
That was a tough one for Allen because Carlson had plenty of daylight to walk up the gut. Good hard slap shot, just high and hard on their goaltender.
Carlson, every ounce of that shot was
sure
pounded
did.
There.
Yeah, he did.
One shot on the man advantage for Washington as it ticks away. Backus is back to the playing surface. Parayko going wide. Winnick and Orlov there to bookend him in the corner. Richards breaks it away, looking for Galiev sprinting down the flank against Backus. Stan Galiev shoved to the backboards. With 1:50 separating us from Capitals Intermission Live, presented by CIS Secure Computing. Allen makes the stick save. Mark him down for 9 in the period. Winnick to the front door. That came right on through. Troy Brouwer all alone will work back ahead.
That was a good opportunity for Galiev. He got that puck away in a hurry.
Off the toe drag. No room for Paul Stastny. Orlov's going to take this from Grubauer. Flushed out by Schwartz. Dmitry Orlov's pass knocked out of the air. Berglund, a very long reach at 6'5". He's out there with Tarasenko and Schwartz for the moment. Laterra is normally the pivot for those two wingers. Give and go to the slot. Allen with the save on Wilson, and he'll melt the rebound.
That's a beautiful set play there. Very close to being a hook and call with the Capitals going aggressively up the middle to the net. Watch the play in the neutral zone. Good speed, a give and go. Breaking through the middle. Real nice job by Willie. Just a pretty good hook from behind. Just legal enough to not draw the penalty by Edmondson, the young defenseman. Watch him just get his stick. Didn't touch his hands there. When you watch that replay closely, could have been very close to a hook right there when he caught that lower hand on the second look that we just had.
Tom Wilson, who will turn 22 next week, back to the bench for Washington. A little bit more than a minute with which to work in the opening period. Petteri Lindbom, number 48 in the white, a 22-year-old Finn, pressed into service tonight. Carl Gunnarsson, a late scratch. Backus bothered there by Niskanen, as Alsner will play catch with his trusty partner. Carl Alsner celebrated his 500th NHL game last night. Burakovsky maneuvering at the line. Kuznetsov had to get back onside. This is Niskanen on the rush. To the trailer, Johansson. Snapshot on the way, deflected wide. That changed radically on Allen.
Not only height, but also speed. Knuckled towards the goal.
Final 18 seconds of the first. Shattenkirk there, a rough run to Burakovsky. Gets right back in his face again. As you see those two push and shove. 8 seconds left. Niskanen one-timer stopped by Allen. And the rebound is out of play. Jake Allen and Philip Grubauer both sharp in this first period.
And Kuznetsov involved with a couple of blues. Burakovsky coming in. They're just going to spread out here and go off to their respective benches for a line change here. Under 6 to go as the Blues look along.
Well, guys, while we have an opportunity, we want to invite everybody to join our conversation, as always, on Twitter, as we ask you tonight, who will represent the Western Conference in the Stanley Cup Finals? Get your opinions into hashtag Capitals Talk. And, boys, I know we have got one rather loyal viewer out in Anaheim. I'm wondering who he may decide is going to represent the Western Conference.
State of California, eh? Rugged Western Conference playoffs. We've mentioned how St. Louis has sputtered come the springtime. Jake Allen and the Blues looking sharp so far tonight. Done with 20. Philip Grubauer and the Caps involved in another 0-0 tie after one. Capitals Intermission Live is presented by CIS Secure Computing. Off to the studio pretty soon. Highlights and stats from this one. And our ringside reporter will have a guest. We'll be sending you back to Al Koken in a matter of moments. 13 other games today and tonight. Super huge Saturday. This one comes your way on CSN. No score. Sebastian Salazar and Alan May, all yours. The Blues and the Capitals, they have the best one-goal game winning percentages in the NHL. They're used to playing tight contests. 20 minutes complete, no score in D.C. Thompson Creek with this window of opportunity. Locker, we remember this guy.
Yeah, four seasons here in Washington for Troy Brouwer, dealt in that DJ Oshie deal. Troy Brouwer getting pumped up, some signs in the building tonight, trying to get the boys fired up in his return to Washington, giving out some souvenirs. And of course, you've got to honor a former Cap, and the Capitals fans did that in the first period for number 36, Troy Brouwer.
As we tip our cap to all the men and women in our technical crew this evening for you with the NHL on CSN, there's Kurt Farmer, top of the screen, right to, wearing the hat. RoboCam operator for us. Great to see him out and about and hope that he's back.
Gets a little telestration too.
Part of our team soon enough again. As the Caps faithful welcome Washington to Verizon Center for a date with the St. Louis Blues. Only the Devils and Canucks have the night off. 28 teams in action this Saturday. Ovechkin, a snapshot that was blocked. Jake Allen is in the goal for St. Louis. Philip Grubauer at the opposite end for Washington. Shots on goal were 10-8 in the first, favor D.C. Petrangelo gets the line, a long wrister that's turned away by Brooks Orpik. Orpik's among the NHL leaders in block shots this month.
Yeah, only Beauchemin more than our own Brooks Orpik.
Allen uses that goalie stick well, finds Petrangelo through center for a dump in. Burakovsky reloads with the help of Orpik. Orlov goes glass to play it on down. And this should be icing against Washington.
Icing against the Caps. The Caps on home ice for Barry Trotz. 2-2, the record of 30 wins on home ice, set back in 85-86. 22-3-1 for Barry on home ice the last 26 games. Trotz and Ken Hitchcock are very good buddies. They take a lot of knowledge from each other. They were chumming it up prior to the game here tonight.
Barry says he's learned a lot from Ken, whether it's being in conversation with him or coaching against him. Blues are in town with nothing on the board. Parayko throws to the front. Stopped there by Grubauer. Shattenkirk fires and Grubauer took the angle away. Tarasenko below the goal line. Hide and seek against Orpik. Tarasenko's pass to the slot clicks to the corner. Second minute of the second period. Long wrister, Grubauer has that surrounded. Folks from the promo department, 2016-17, full season ticket memberships are on sale now. Guarantee your access to the same great seats for the Stanley Cup playoffs this spring. The opportunity to buy ticket packages for the World Cup in the fall. For more info, visit a sales table here at Verizon or call 202-266-CAPS. Grubauer peeking out from his goal crease on a snapshot that goes wide from Berglund. Blues have won 10 of their last 13 on the road. Alsner straightened up by Backes. Beagle will bunt it to center. Two teams are 5-on-5. Early stages of the middle frame. Very hard to move through neutral zone when St. Louis is playing properly. Ditto for Washington for that matter. Bortuzzo's long wrister is eaten up by Grubauer and there's no rebound.
And then a little shot to the back of Alsner and Chimera didn't like that extra shot. Bortuzzo into the lineup. He's a guy that racks up pims. One of the tougher defensemen in the lineup for the St. Louis Blues. He's a big rig. Pushes guys around and gets involved.
Former Pittsburgh Penguins.
Here's the play, little shot, innocent enough, but here comes Bertuzzo. There's that little shot against the lower part of the back. And you'll notice, there it is, not called, and into the corner he went, and that's when Chimera got a piece of him and had a little talk to after that shot to Carl Alsner.
Bertuzzo turned 27 last week. He was brought to St. Louis by these Blues for Ian Cole. Faceoff in the offensive zone. St. Louis, its 49th season in the NHL. They entered the league in the expansion of 1967 when the NHL doubled in size. Galiev working the wall. The Caps joined the party in 1974. Upshaw one-hands it ahead, but not out. Down low, Allen makes the save there. An in-tight chance from Galiev.
Yeah, Galiev's had a good game so far. He's been involved. Last night, not a whole lot of ice time. Under about 9 minutes overall in New Jersey. But here tonight, he's had a couple of good looks. That one, the best of the night. Sharp angle shot. And you see the goaltender, Jake Allen, really not giving him any meshing behind him. Looking for his first goal of the season. His third round pick of 2010.
His first ever NHL goal was authored against Henrik Lundqvist of the New York Rangers. Rangers involved in a 1-1 tie with Montreal tonight as Parayko takes the puck for St. Louis. Badgered immediately by Alex Ovechkin. Off the wall, Williams fires, a kick-out stop for Allen. Jake Allen, this is the first time he's ever faced Washington. Fabry goes the other way. Brouwer fires from the angle, Grubauer with a shoulder stop, and then he follows the rebound. Folks, back to 1967. The league adds six, including these Blues. As far as those teams to have won Stanley Cups, have a peek.
Yeah, the Kings, the Flyers, and the Penguins. The Blues have yet to win one. Minnesota won the Cup as the Dallas Stars. California Golden Seals, you remember that team. They all were decked out in white skates when they first came into the league.
Looking like the Oakland A's for the baseball
ranks. They sure did, yes.
Same owner, right? Charlie Finley?
Yes.
23-year-old Jaden Schwartz looking on. Schwartz, Laterra, and Tarasenko for Ken Hitchcock on ice.
And they call that the STL line in St. Louis.
It fits. Almost 3 minutes deep in period two as Schwartz will hack it past Niskanen. Tarasenko on the run, beaten to the punch by Alsner. At point position, Petrangelo finds Laterra. Tarasenko knifing to the net. Grubauer with the pad save. Petrangelo shimmies around Kuznetsov. Schwartz bottled up by Alsner. Carl Alsner takes it back. Pressure comes quickly, though, from Laterra, a 28-year-old Finn. Edmondson launched it wide. Shoveled to the slot by Backes and right on through, and it kickstarts the breakout for Marcus Johansson. 3-on-2 developing. Snapshot coming, blocked by the defense of Lindbom, keeping tabs on Burakovsky. Shots on goal are 15-12, favor St. Louis. Yashkin maneuvers through center on the dump in, it's Berglund. Grubauer waits for it to get into the trapezoid, spins it along. Backes, sharp angle, kicked away. Lindbom towards the cage, deflected. 5-on-5 play continues with no score on the big board. Backes, a snap pass that was eaten up. Back comes Washington. Chimera was in that lane. He'll scoop it clear. Allen keeps it humming. Yashkin right up the gut for the Blues. Looking to Backes, who is denied by Orlov. Chimera and Wilson going to goal. Tom Wilson leaves it to the turning Beagle. Berglund gives him a bump. Wilson carries it to the corner. Bertuzzo able to put the clamps on it. Back comes Backes for St. Louis. Orlov turns. Heard the freight train coming. Backes makes a steal. Upshaw fires. That was blocked. Backes is follow. Rebound, they score. At the front door, a tap-in for Brodziak.
Man, Brodziak got to that cage. Backes really the big factor on the forecheck, hunting down Dmitry Orlov. Tried a little move off the back of the net that didn't work out, and they kept the puck alive. And Brodziak will get the goal right on the doorstep. after that shot from Backes. Here's the chase. There's a little move by Orlov. He gets the puck taken from him. Backes shoots once and then twice. And there's the puck on Brodziak's stick. Sharp angle shot. The loose puck off the catching glove of Grubauer. Tough to contain. Actually might have went through him and goes right onto Brodziak's stick. 1-0 for the St. Louis Blues.
Brodziak had the shorthanded goal last night. So goals in consecutive games. The first time he's ever scored against Washington. And this is 10th meeting with the Caps. Giving the Blues the advantage at 4:45. Parayko tied up along the wall with Galiev. Shattenkirk's outlet denied by Winnick. Upshaw will clear it in. St. Louis on top by one as we've crossed the five-minute mark of the second period. Parayko leaving it down low. Brodziak waits for it. Drops the puck behind the cage. John Carlson was right there as the Caps will clear. Galiev motors after Shattenkirk. Winnick closing. Fires, just missed it high. Daniel Winnick, who had a two-goal game here against Nashville in recent memory, will deflect this behind the Blues' goal. Allen sweeps it on around. Williams took the boards away, but Upshaw will get it out. Brouwer goes one-on-one against Alsner. Works to a wrister. Pad save for Grubauer.
We've seen that a lot of practice time. Notice Alsner doesn't give him a whole lot of looks. He doesn't give anybody looks. Hard for Troy just to get that sharp angle shot on net.
Backstrom slithers through. Williams in tight and Allen with a good pad save. Niskanen winds and fires and Jake Allen traps it against his chest. 6 minutes, 8 seconds into period two. St. Louis drawing first blood. And it comes from Kyle Brodziak. On their side, St. Louis has the 1-0 advantage. The assist leaders are presented by your local Hyundai dealers. Let them assist you in scoring the lowest prices on the hottest lineup in America. Kuznetsov not shy at home.
No, second best only Erik Karlsson of the Senators better than Kuzi dishing it out on home ice. Goudreau, Wheeler, Jumbo, Joe, all guys that have excelled on their home ice.
Yevgeny Kuznetsov's gone 3 games without a point. Trying to change that tonight against the visiting St. Louis Blues. Blues with one of the best road goals against averages in all the NHL. Stout defense and a top net minding tandem as Ovechkin works around the defender, did not pull the trigger. Brouwer slings it along for Fabry. Stastny there in his wake. Fabry to the front, deflected. Whoa, Grubauer to the splits that just hold that post long enough.
Yeah, that pad was coming off indeed, Joe, because he was playing the opposite side there on that puck. That puck was looking to go across, and lucky for him, that right leg stayed tight.
Edmondson, sharp angle, feed to the front. Orpik on patrol, didn't get it out. Brower's slapper was muffled. Troy Brouwer getting help from Stastny. Looking to Edmondson, that pinballs to the waiting Justin Williams. He'll snake his way through center and send it hard around. Caps in the middle of a change. 1-0 St. Louis. Brodziak's fifth of the season. The long send away. Fabry was decked by Niskanen. No icing here as Alsner enters the picture. Niskanen moves it along. One touch to the outside. Kuznetsov looking for the redirect. It's vacuumed up by Jake Allen. Folks, Burke and Herbert Bank, they score for the kids. For every Caps goal scored this season, Burke and Herbert Bank. They're donating $100 to most valuable kids. MVK turning empty seats into meaningful experiences for underserved kids who otherwise might not have a chance to attend these great sporting events. Fine work by MVK and Burke and Herbert Bank. 7:17 gone by in the second. Shattenkirk dangerously in front of his own goal. Schwartz sandwiched by Alsner and Niskanen. Niskanen a rough run to the boards. The failed clear. Hoisted towards the cage. Tarasenko flattened Niskanen with a heavy hit.
That was sort of a counterattack by Tarasenko. He took the body instead of the puck. And he was able to jump that puck and get it free from Niskanen.
Turnover. Burakovsky waits on the delay. One more pass to the slot. Allen, a beautiful read to stop Johansson. Schwartz goes two on two with Tarasenko. crisscrossing. There's Tarasenko in the slot, denied by Niskanen. Laterra will rake it down low as we near the midway mark of regulation time. Carlson steadily out of his own end. Niskanen right on target for Beagle. Beagle works on Bortuzzo on the drop. That's a headhunter as Allen was ducking for cover. A bullet shot from Jason Chimera came his way. Backus to Yashkin. Berglund fires, and that's snapped out of the air by Philip Grubauer.
A great opportunity for the Caps on an errant pass up the middle by the St. Louis Blues. Here they rotate around. The Caps try to work a three-on-one, and Mojo is denied on the doorstep. Good rip-off on the turnover, and then Barakovsky finds the late guy coming. Kuznetsov in a good opportunity down low. Watch this counter hit. He leaves the puck. That could have easily been called interference. The puck outside of Tarasenko's stick. That is a counterattack in the biggest way.
Saw that last night between Devontae Smith-Pelly and Carl Alsner while we were in Newark. As the Caps are in onside here, there was another huge collision.
Ooh,
Winnick is slow
hurting
to get back up.
Yep.
Daniel Winnick on his knees, woozily getting back to his feet.
Yeah, that D stepped right up on Daniel Winnick. And he's coming right over to the bench here. I like to see the fact that Big Daniel's up. Watch this play along the wall right there. And that's backtracking coming up the middle. And that's the youngster, Edmondson, that caught him. Coming right across there, right into the chest. And Winnick's down. I like the fact that he's able to get up and get over to the bench after taking that big hit.
Joel Edmondson, selected in the 2011 draft, one after another. It just seems like the Blues are producing big, powerful defenders who make their presence felt year after year.
And the Caps have to start getting some more shots on Allen. This period, it's 14-6 St. Louis, Joe.
Lindbom, his drive's deflected. It winds up out of play. Philip Grubauer and the Caps entertaining the Blues, one of, 14 on the day and night. Pittsburgh all over Detroit earlier today. Minnesota, a big win for the Wild. Dallas, two better than San Jose. New York involved with the Canadiens tonight. JT Miller's on the board. Toronto and Boston squaring off. Ottawa has a 2-0 advantage over visiting Anaheim. Florida and Tampa, 2-1 for the Panthers. Jaromir Jagr on the score sheet for the Floridians.
After that last play, the puck hit the meshing behind the net. Actually, Grubauer caught it. The linesman went over to get a puck, and he still had it in his glove. Skated by him and still yelled at him and said, "Hey, get this puck out of my glove."
He trapped it off the ice and put it in the glove as Reeves closes and fires. Good recovery, though, by defender John Carlson there. A loose puck. Claimed by Washington. Good to see Winnick swerving through center after that rugged collision with Edmondson. Hopefully just the wind knocked out of him. Lindbom covering up on Winnick. Nearing the midway mark of the second period. We were nothing after one. Orlov pumps this one right onto the glove of Jake Allen. As advertised, Allen is cool as a cucumber in there. His footwork is really good. He manages his depth very well.
And it hasn't really been the case for Allen. He's sort of been up and down. He loses three, wins six, but he's lost two in a row. His last two, four goals on 17 shots, lasted 31 minutes and a loss to the Flames. The next night he goes in, five goals on 26 shots and a 6-4 loss to the Oilers. This is a type of play, though, you're seeing from Jake Allen that the Blues really like. They got a real good tandem between him and Elliott. It's going to be interesting to see who's the starter come the playoffs.
Elliott, of course, the hot guy now with the three straight shutouts for the Blues after his return from injury. Backstrom quickly looking for Williams. It'll bounce away and force Washington to rewind through center. Alex Ovechkin on the run. Drops to Williams. The snapshot, blocker pad save for Allen. Mark him down for 18 on the night.
Hitch is hard on goalies, isn't it?
So I've heard.
Yeah. If you step up a little bit, you get the play. If you don't, you're usually on the bench and watch it.
Fabry ducking in at the line. This is offside against St. Louis.
And I think there'll be coincidental minors coming up, Joe.
1-0 Blues. Al Kokin and a special guest on the other side of the break with the NHL on CSN.
Jarry broke the color barrier in the National Hockey League. This man became the second black player in the NHL. And as an original Washington Capitol, Mike Marson, justifiably honored tonight in this building. What did that mean to you?
Wow. Unbelievable, Al. Everybody was looking at me and clapping their hands. Jubilation.
As we mentioned, long overdue. Mike, your career was fascinating, but your post-hockey career has been equally fascinating. Tell people some of the things you've been involved with.
Well, I got involved with the martial arts, which is a very interesting study, and it's just something that you do every day. You practice hard, and it kind of took the place for me of playing hockey.
Well, 60 seconds doesn't do Mike Marson credit. We recommend the documentary Soul on Ice, Breaking the Ice, The Black Experience in Professional Hockey. Those are things that you need to read. And guys, I'll leave you with this. 16 goals right out of junior hockey on one of the worst NHL teams ever. How about that man, Mike Marson, in his rookie year?
Thanks, Al. Thank you very much.
Truly a remarkable story. Mike Marson honored tonight as Kuznetsov wheels into the offensive zone. Challenged by Shattenkirk, Yevgeny Kuznetsov waltzing through the slot now. Playing keep away on a centering pass. That's Parayko. Always in good shape. He's the Blues plus-minus leader.
Yeah, they're really reading well the Capitals' second and third looks in the offensive zone.
Parayko fires and scores.
Well, he makes a defensive play at one end, and this is a leaky goal by Grubauer. One on two or one on three, and Parayko buries it, adding to his plus-minus that you just mentioned, Joe. That one right through the wickets. Grubauer. Parayko from end to end. Here he comes. He breaks up the play, and notice no one and white coming in. A couple of guys maybe on the wings, but it was even Steven, and here's the shot. And it goes right underneath the pads of Grubauer, one that he's going to stop 9 out of 10 times. Just a lucky shot that eludes the goaltender, hits the right inside of the right pad. Parayko and the Blues up 2-0.
Parayko gets his 8th, snapping a 19-game drought. I think he's a shoe-in for the NHL's all-rookie team. This may be challenged due to an offside.
Yes, it is.
Referees Kelly Sutherland and Dean Morton, specifically referee Sutherland, informing the crowd that this play has been challenged. So the linesman will get the tablet out and make the assessment. Remember, the puck has to be the first into the zone.
Looks offside on the far side, Joe. Tarasenko looks all right. I would give him the benefit of the doubt, but right over here, the man on the right side there's his skate blade. And to me, that's close to being over before the puck is completely across the blue line. You're going to have to take a look at this several times to determine the offside.
As Schwartz is crossing over, that leg, that skate that's coming up, leaves just one skate down, and it's across the line, which is offside.
Yep, here it is. Here he's
moving.
There's
the crossover.
Yep.
Up. And in, so he's ahead of the puck.
Yes, he is. He's ahead of the puck because the puck is still on the blue line. This should work well for Grubauer and the Caps.
Now, it's the linesman, Brian Murphy and Scott Driscoll, who will make the call. They have to overturn their original call and see evidence that leads them to believe that the Blues were offside before Parayko's wrister. 11:05, the time of the tally. We have the information. And here's the ruling. Sutherland is making sure.
After video review, the play is onside. Therefore, good call.
Wow. We can never guess right, can we?
I'm not trying to guess,
no.
Locker. I'm really not. And I get more and more confused every time I see different replays.
I don't mean that we're guessing.
No, I know.
We're looking at it, and I'm saying
his
that's offside.
Up.
Right there, it's up and it's complete. The puck is not over, and the far side is not over. I just think that's an offsides call.
The only point of contact for Schwartz was offside. His trail skate was up in the air. I don't know the rules anymore, apparently. 2-0 St. Louis. Parayko, his 8th at 11:05. I was saying, I think he's a shoe-in for the all-rookie team. His netminder, Jake Allen, was on that all-rookie team last year with the likes of Forsberg, Goudreau, Stone, Klingberg, and Ekblad. Pretty good company. Parayko should be right there again on the back end. As John Carlson walks back through center. Berglund drifting. Snapshot that's rejected by Orpik. As Backstrom plays it to the corner boards, Backus loses his stick, and Washington comes back the other way. Ovechkin for Carlson on the toe drag. Petrangelo keeps him to the outside. Johansson swoops in, makes the stick check. Carlson round and round. Johansson fires. Jake Allen the save, and he'll calmly sweep it for the Petrangelo clear.
Man, you mentioned his skates and the way he moves in net. Does he ever look like he's in the zone tonight, Jake Allen? The Caps are going to have to worm their way around him to pot a goal here tonight to get back in this game.
Just reading the papers, the local ones in St. Louis, Allen's had a lot of good practice time lately. He felt very comfortable about his game. All the while, Brian Elliott was throwing shutout after shutout. Allen gets his chance and looks sharp. Laterra feeds to the slot. That's a beautiful play. And a slam dunk layup for Tarasenko.
Well, that's that STL line moving around the puck. Yeah, a little bit of triangulation down low against Barry Trotz's team. Tarasenko and company work their magic in front of the cage. A Grubauer, but it's a three-man unit out there that flow the puck around. Schwartz, Laterra, Tarasenko. Here's that little pass, and it's a wide-open net. Niskanen can't protect in front. It's hard for him to even have a chance to stop that puck. But here's the play down low. The passing play that pulls everybody out of position. Tarasenko's in front of the net, gets away from Niskanen, opens up, and Tarasenko has his 35th. 3-0 Blues.
By the way, 18 of those 35 in the second period alone. He lights it up in the middle stanza. 1 minute, 40 seconds after the Parayko goal, it's 3-0 for the Blues. Both of these teams in action last night. St. Louis thumped Vancouver 4-0. Washington was the winner in overtime. Richards turns, drops it, as Upshaw was waiting for Winnick. Capitals victorious 1-0 over the Devils on a John Carlson slap shot winner. Orpik towards the cage. Bortuzzo has it surrounded. And Upshaw will work back through center. This St. Louis team, when they get a lead, it's almost lights out.
It's strangle time,
yes.
And that's what they do. They sit back now, and now they'll play in a defensive posture and just smother you and suffocate you.
On the run, Berglund. Collared there by Carlson. This will bounce back to Philip Grubauer. Grubauer's last appearance was in relief in Pittsburgh. His last start came out west in San Jose. Tending the twine tonight for Washington. And Pierce three times in this middle period. Kuznetsov darting out of the corner. Leaves it to point position for Schmidt. Tried to get it right back to Kuznetsov. On the night when his action figure has been handed out here at Verizon Center. Pretty good likeness, I might add. Petrangelo will clear it in. Ken Hitchcock wants the chain.
Man, it's a celebration one. We need one of those sellies here tonight to get back in the game.
The celebration from his game 7-game winner against the Islanders in the playoffs last year. Ovechkin on the go with Williams on the interchange. Nothing there for Washington. Stastny goes board to board to Parayko. And he'll dump it in. Grubauer giving the marching orders for Carlson and Williams as the Blues turn up their forecheck. Always a very disciplined squad in that regard. Fabry off the turnover looking for Brouwer. His deep slot pass taken away by Alex Ovechkin. Ovechkin dodging two defenders. On the flank for Williams. No TJ Oshie, the former Blue tonight. Continues to be battling flu-like symptoms. Plan is for him to skate on his own tomorrow. They're sort of keeping him in quarantine away from the guys. There's a delayed penalty call coming up against the Blues. Grubauer to the bench, six attackers on with 4:40 to go in the second period. Williams on the back pedal. Delayed penalty against the Blues. Johansson gaining ground through center. Around Tarasenko, greeted at the line, and that's where the play stops. When we return after this commercial break, the Caps will have the power play. Congrats to Mike Marcin, honored here at Verizon Center. The NHL on CSN continues after these words. Blues on top by three. This evening's Cold Hard Facts, they're brought to you by Clean Crisp Coors Light. The Caps have been A-OK when facing the West.
Joe B, they've lost his 5 times in 23 tries versus the Western Conference. Kuznetsov leads the Eastern Conference with 34 points in those 23 games versus the West.
Blues struck 3 times on 7 shots in 8 minutes exactly to take this 3-0 advantage. The Capitals attempt to carve into that. Wrist shot coming, it sailed high. Just saw the power play stats packaged by the UPS store. Niskanen on the flank to Backstrom. Nicholas points it for Niskanen. One-timer Ovechkin, that goes high. Backstrom will regroup. Berglund looking after his fellow Swede. Johansson on the rotation play, and it'll click back to center ice.
And it looked like the first time the Blues had it and were clearing the zone actually hit the linesman who kept that play alive in the zone.
Backstrom leads the league in power play assists. He posts up along the wall. Ovechkin one-timer, stick save Allen. Niskanen does not keep it in. 108 with which to work on the man advantage. 3.5 to go, second period. All Blues in this frame. Backes will clear in. Backes getting an assist on the Brodziak goal. Tarasenko was set up by Laterra and Stastny. Parayko unassisted. Kuznetsov streaming in. Parayko closing ranks. Colton Parayko with room, and he'll send Niskanen packing. He'll instead change and allow Williams, or rather Carlson, to regroup.
Has a little pronger in him, that youngster, Joe. The way he skates, he looks very similar in stature also.
I knew you'd like him once you saw him.
I sure do.
Bortuzzo. Around the wall it comes for Washington on the man advantage, Carlson. This way to Kuznetsov. Steps to a better shooting lane and fires, just missed that top corner. Burakovsky hanging out in the slot right there. Allen, another sharp save in the cover.
Not only the save, but how good has he been on rebounds? The Capitals over a minute of zone time on this power play. Look at how close to the pads this rebound comes. Here comes Ovi on the retrieval. They move it around, and look at where that puck lies. That means you are on your game. Most goaltenders, and a lot of them in this situation, kick the rebound out higher, which gives the opposition another chance. Real good rebound control by Allen tonight.
Carlson steps in, fires a laser beam that went wide. Big rebound along the boards. Galiev can't get it, as Shattenkirk will leave the sin bin right now with 2:25 remaining in period two. Carlson into the flow with Winnick on the clear end. Petrangelo tied up with Galiev. Blues back to 5-on-5 and racing back through center here. To the outside, it's Shattenkirk rolling it wide of Grubauer in the cage for Washington tonight. Dmitry Orlov gaining some ground through center. Orlov skipping out wide. Finds Richards. Mike Richards leaves it for Carl Alsner. Double teamed to the wall by Laterra and Tarasenko. Winnick finds Orlov. Orlov's wrister was melted. There's Tarasenko in the way. Petrangelo will turn. A lift check supplied to him from Winnick. Blues don't get it out on the first try, but do so on the second effort.
Just about 11 periods for the St. Louis Blues, with teams having no luck striking pay dirt and scoring. The Capitals would like to change that around. The St. Louis Blues now giving up some chances. The Capitals are going to have to continue putting rubber Allen's way.
Elliott with those 3 straight shutouts. Jake Allen has 5 shutouts this season. Williams on the go. Curl and drag move erased by Bortuzzo. And the puck is out of play.
Yeah, it's one and done for the Caps a lot of times. They haven't been able to have flurries against the St. Louis Blues here tonight on their home ice. Pretty good road team. Similar numbers on road and at home for Ken Hitchcock. Coach behind the bench with over 750 wins on his resume.
That's a very rich resume. Caps entertaining the Blues tonight. 3-0 for St. Louis. All the sparks provided in the second period. Burakovsky, his pass towards the slot, rejected. In the final minute now of the second frame, Kuznetsov drags it to the slot. Pad save, Allen. He was leaning and still managed to get back. Orpik shimmies loose with help from Kuznetsov. Burakovsky through center. 38 ticks remaining in the period. St. Louis swept a pair from Washington last year. Someone named TJ Oshie had 4 assists in those 2 games. Oshie not available again for Washington tonight.
Well, Jimmy Corsi, we just saw upstairs here in the booth. He's the goaltender coach. He was the guy on the left. He's got to be really happy with the way Allen has played here tonight.
On the flank comes Fabry with 10 seconds to go. Good defensive play there by Carlson. Through center, Beagle behind Chimera. 4 seconds left. Wilson's at the top of the forecheck. Shattenkirk goes to the boards and the horn sounds. Ending 2 in D.C. St. Louis in control. And Jake Allen looking extremely sharp. Brodziak, Parayko, and Tarasenko back to back to back. The Blues lead by a bunch after 40. Capitals Intermission Live is presented by CIS Secure Computing. Off to the studio soon. Highlights and stats from this one. And Locker should be telestrating before too long. Jake Allen against Philip Grubauer in the netminding matchup. Ken Hitchcock is pleased. The Blues have the lead. Sebastian and Allen, take it away. Washington Capitals back at home. Alex Ovechkin and friends entertaining the St. Louis Blues with the Blues on top by 3. These were the Acura stats through 2.
Yeah, real good second period for the Blue Shirts. Or the Blue Notes, excuse me. 24-23 scoring chances. Favor the Caps by a 4 spot. The St. Louis Blues out hitting the Caps by a wide margin. The Caps not very good with puck management, as Alan May likes to say. Too many giveaways against Allen and his mates.
Jake Allen, very impressive resume. Philip Grubauer at the other end for Washington. Allen was a major junior goalie of the year back in 2010. He was the American Hockey League's goalie of the year. They knew they had a prized pupil coming through the ranks. And Allen now with 24 victories this season, whitewashing the Capitals to this point in the contest. Back to point position. Brooks Orpik will retreat. That high pass staggered Robbie Fabry, the rookie in the Blues lineup. St. Louis still without Jay Bouwmeester, normally an ultra-durable defender. Same two for Alex Steen. As Tarasenko hits the throttle, comes cross-rink. Laterra shakes it for Schwartz. Back to point position. Tarasenko snapshot. Missed it on the short side, and the rebound will roll all the way onto the Blues' half. Colton Parayko, one of the 3 goal scorers in the second period. Brodziak and Tarasenko, the others for these Blues, who have had no troubles winning on the road this season. Laterra dumps it in. Grubauer will cut it off. Place it around the dasher. Backes knocked it down. Yashkin fires, and it's deflected away by Niskanen.
Yeah, good stick work there by Niskanen against Yashkin. Trying to get that puck to the net, trying to put it upstairs against the Capitals' netminder. He was looking for his 5th against Niskanen, who just eats up ice time for this hockey team. You never seem to see him off the ice when you watch the Caps. That's number 2.
Washington overall has won 41 of its last 55. Tremendous season for the Caps. A chance for them today to clinch the President's Trophy should they gain any kind of point tonight. Or if the Stars were to lose to the Sharks. Last check, Dallas was on top comfortably in that game. As Barry Trotz checks the scoreboard. His troops trailing Ken Hitchcock's by 3. Washington and St. Louis have split the last 4 meetings here at Verizon Center. Caps will see the Blues at Scott Trade Center on April 9th. That has not been a friendly place for Washington of late. Just 2 wins in the last 10 visits. 2 teams are at even in full strength, 5-on-5. Backes will drag it out of the corner. Leave it along the boards. Berglund looking for Backes again. Tight checking continues as you look down the dasher. Yashkin tying it up. Referees giving the boys a long leash. Kelly Sutherland and Dean Morton tonight.
Good!
As Niskanen plops it wide of Allen. He bunts it to the glass, and the Blues will clear. Charging back, working to the outside. Yashkin lowers the shoulder. Good angle by Schmidt. Backus is next in line. Olympic teammate John Carlson close by. Brodziak twists it down low. Petrangelo jumping right in from point position. Hammered there along the wall by Jason Chimera. On the dump in, Carlson doing the honors. Fresh folks coming over the boards for Washington. NHL action on CSN. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan upstairs, Al Kokin, your ringside reporter. We shout out thanks to all the men and women in our technical crew as the puck leaves the playing surface for a whistle. Folks, Capitals premium ticket packages are on sale now for the 2016 Stanley Cup playoffs. Round one, home games 1-3. Watching pregame warmups in the penalty box, enjoying a reserve table for four throughout the night in the Acela Club. The Caps have you covered. For more information, 202-266-CAPS. Mike Marson looking on from one of the Sky Suites here at Verizon. Stastny's pass was deflected away after Willie O'Ree. Marson was the second man to break the NHL's color barrier. Played with the Washington Capitals in the 70s. Stastny working. Knifing right to the cage. Made one more pass there. Deflects at the goal, and Grubauer holds onto it long enough for the whistle.
Good rotation there by Stastny, and then there was sort of a parting of the seas. He had a lot of daylight up the middle. Looking to get into double digits in goals. He's made a push the last month or so, racking up more points. 11 points his last eight. Here's Stastny. Comes from a hockey family, of course. His dad, Peter. There's that play down low, and here's the rotation. Using the top of the circle, the distance between the defense and the forwards who are covering the point, and he found himself a lane.
His alma mater is still alive in the NCAA hockey tournament. As far as the Frozen Four is concerned, Fighting Hawks of North Dakota have punched their ticket through. Frozen Four at Amalie Arena in Tampa this year. Tarasenko scoops one towards the slot. Backstrom was on patrol, and Ovechkin will clear to center. Nearing the 4-minute mark in his third period.
Wasn't he Denver?
Stastny?
Yeah.
Indeed.
Denver, and they've had a good run too, right?
In the mix still.
Excellent, good season, yeah.
On around, it will be Nate Schmidt, played collegiately at Minnesota. On for Ovechkin. Berglund on a take back for the Blues. From his knees, he'll swat it ahead. Yashkin will clear in. Grubauer helping his defenders. John Carlson will switch it up for Nate Schmidt. Caps fans on this Saturday night making their voices heard. Kuznetsov speeds through center. Evgeny Kuznetsov to the outside. Drags one to the front. It'll get away from Allen. The centering pass came right on through. Sharp angle bid from the outside of the goal. Quick centering pass from Johansson gets away from Burakovsky, and the Caps will chase it down.
There was some daylight there for Burakovsky. Just couldn't handle that hard pass. Had to be hard to give that separation, and he would have had a good shot.
Blues working through neutral ice. Niskanen with a step up on Brodziak. And Alzner will play it away from the hard-charging Ryan Reeves, who's about 240 pounds a hockey player.
You don't want to run into him anytime.
No. Stuff attempt. Fabry shut down by Grubauer. Beagle comes rumbling out of his own zone. Jay Beagle for Washington. To the outside. Timing play. Allen sniffed it out, and he has it beneath his pads. A super look for Chimera at the doorstep.
Yeah, real good net drive. Chimera using his speed, but it's been that type of night for Allen. Everything that's touched him, he's kept underneath him. No loose change. Beautiful play. Timing by Beagle, and there's Allen. You mentioned it, Joe. Reacting, anticipating, felt the pressure coming from the offside, the weak side, and here's a look at Chimera skating at full speed. Pareko did not have his body on him, got inside leverage with a good scoring chance.
25-year-old Allen making his 45th appearance of the season. Galiev hopes to test him here. blocked. Follow-up from Alsner, that's rammed wide. Stan Galiev turns the corner. Bortuzzo bumps him down to the ice. The Blues will play it away. As Niskanen looks to Alsner. Carl Alsner cruising back through center. He'll dump it in. Washington with a healthy scratches today. Taylor Chorney and Mike Weber in back. Michael Latta not getting a jersey for duty tonight. The centering pass came right to the waiting Stastny. Paul Stastny content to drop it off. Bortuzzo can take his sweet time now on the clear. 13:50 left in regulation. Lindbom. Ooh, that one bounced off the noggin of Schwartz. Uncomfortable feeling for him.
They need him to be healthy when he's in the lineup. The Blues are a much better hockey team, and he's been banged up the last couple of seasons.
Tarasenko takes it off the boards. Vladimir Tarasenko for a Schwartz stuff. Knocked away by Grubauer. Backstrom feathers it to Justin Williams. Williams in the lineup on the top line once again. TJ Oshie continues to be under the weather. Missing this chance to face his former mates for the first time. Williams goes indirectly to Backstrom. Petrangelo latching on. Backstrom swivels one right on through Ovechkin, who was waiting at the post. Williams serves it out wide. Carlson playing keep away. Williams, high slot, wicked slapper coming. Allen the save, and he'll squeeze after Schmidt sent a BB his way. 7 minutes and 8 seconds gone by in the third. The Great Eight frustrated tonight on CSN. The technology you need when you need it. Troy Brouwer has returned with the Blues tonight.
A little salute to the fans. Nice job by the fans here acknowledging him. Rodziak now goals in back-to-back games. He's got his fifth goal of the season here tonight, a shorty last night. And Tarasenko has got his 35th on a layup in front. Those goals are fourth most in the National Hockey League.
Tarasenko, who had one against Washington last season. The Blues got all three in the middle frame, as you can tell. NHL action on CSN. At the American Hockey League level, Hershey and Albany are 2-2 after two. The Bears have tallies from a pair of 20-goal scorers. Travis Boyd's 20th. Riley Barber has his 23rd. This date in history, thinking back on familiar March 26th, there have been quite a few big names.
Mr. Consistency, Mike Gartner, Neil Broughton, Tony Esposito, first guy in history with 8 30 win seasons, and the Art Ross, way back in 1931, the first coach to pull a goalie for an extra attacker.
Big names making big news on this date. Locker, what are you doing with your microphone over there, by the way?
What do you mean?
You keep playing with it. It sounds very strange in my headset. Sometimes it's
That's
where
why I'm playing with it.
Sometimes it's where it should be. Other times it's over your head. Through center, it's Shattenkirk on the run. He'll dump it in as we near the 8 minute mark in the third. Schmidt hawked there by Brouwer. Nate Schmidt waiting for a lane to open up, goes indirectly through center. Winnick at the line offside against Washington.
Yeah, Richards just a step over there before that puck was dumped in. That line trying to get some forechecking going. The offsides forces a stoppage of play. Winnick was hit heavily in that second period by the young defenseman, but he's no worse for wear. He's right back out there as we take a look at our Jeep. Shots on net. Second period, St. Louis 16-13. This period, they lead by one.
The young defender of whom you speak, Joel Edmondson, for the moment on Coach Hitchcock's bench. Tarasenko had his pass deflect back into the blue zone, and it's Petteri Lindbom who play here. Bortuzzo moves it through Laterra. Alsner fires, stopped there by Allen. Along the wall. Not a lot of running room for Schwartz. Laterra dropped in his tracks by Richards. And Winnick will find an open Wilson. Snap pass that goes awry. Petrangelo on the take back for St. Louis. All the scoring in this contest coming in the middle period. Rodziak, Parayko, and Tarasenko 7 minutes apart. Ovechkin off the turnover. Alex Ovechkin finds the late guy. It's Williams walking in. And Allen took away the angle there, stepping out to challenge. Ovechkin swivels down low, blocked by Edmondson. Troy Brouwer has time. He doesn't clear. Ovechkin front door. Stopped by Allen. Rebound. They jam for it. And Jake Allen makes the save. And we have fireworks in front.
Well, yeah, because of the pushing and shoving. Alex Ovechkin, two or three whacks at the goalie, trying to push the puck and the goalie into the net. Alex Ovechkin in a bear hug down low with former teammate Troy Brouwer. They just can't get anything past this goaltender, Joe. No matter what they do, he has had their number tonight. Alex Ovechkin had two or three whacks at that loose puck and couldn't put it home. Here's the Keystone Cops. They turn the puck over. There's one. The puck is loose. Two, three, and that right pad. And finally, the Dominic Hasek-like pickup by the goaltender with his blocker glove.
Ovechkin's not going to like the cross check here from Edmondson. Watch. Right across the wrist. Bang.
Yeah, that starts everything. Here's Ovechkin. One more look. Two or three whacks. And there's Edmondson coming in and gives him a good piece of lumber, as you mentioned, Joe B.
Right across the shoulder cap, as the Caps captain will have a seat. Brouwer gets his lid back on, but Edmondson will wind up in the penalty box. Matching minors for Rufford doled out at 9:16.
He's been impressive, Jake Allen. That's amazing. He's able to keep that puck out of the net. Trotz's bunch has had good pressure against Hitchcock's goaltender. Just nothing's breaking for him here tonight on home ice.
An evening after the Capitals set a franchise record for road victories with their decision in New Jersey, Allen has stymied their offensive attack all night long. Little four-on-four for Burakovsky, a wrister that was deflected away, and Backes will take it on the run. Crossing over to play him defensively was Orlov. Andrei Burakovsky has some breathing room, leads it to the trailer, Kuznetsov, defended by Shattenkirk. Orlov works down the boards, works back topside here, shaded by Shattenkirk, outside for Schmidt. Looping that pass behind the back, a look for Orlov and beneath his stick as the Capitals hit the rewind button. Halfway through this third period, no scoring in the frame. 3-0 Blues overall, offside against Washington. We'll have you back downtown for more with the NHL on CSN right after this here at Verizon.
Lead this one 3-0. You know, Brayden Holpe is the type of guy that really is not that impressed with setting individual records. But there is one mark that he does admit he wouldn't mind having, and that is to beat the 48-win mark of one Martin Brodeur. There is Brodeur on the left, ironically sitting there with former Capital Craig Berube, the assistant general manager now in St. Louis. I talked to Martin Brodeur earlier, and he says he doesn't get that much of a chance now because of his new duties to watch Brayden Holpe. What he sees, he likes a lot. And then he smiled, guys, and said, and I really like the fact that he wants to play every night like me. And remember, it was back in that 06-07 season when he set the victory mark of 48 wins in 78 games with those Devils.
One very talented cat in the crease, for sure. Watching from on high tonight, Jake Allen and the Blues adding to their franchise record shutout streak by blanking Washington to this point in regulation. 40 plus minutes more. Petrangelo guided away from the puck by Marcus Johansson. We're 4-on-4 for another 23 seconds. Remember, Parayko's goal in the second came 4-on-4. Big fella has the puck right now, peeking over top of the cage. Shattenkirk, wing to wing to Schwartz. Well defended there by Washington. Chimera will table this for Beagle, just out of his reach. Parayko, picked up by Chimera on his radar. Shattenkirk loops it along, and Schwartz will bring it through center. Backes and Stastny were tied up with Orpik at the attacking line, so Washington has the puck with John Carlson. Orpik's next, lost it there. Backes over skates as we return to 5-on-5 action. Berglund wheeling into the offensive zone. Washington, a date with Columbus on Monday here. We'll keep you company on CSN as Kuznetsov dumps it in. St. Louis will host Colorado on Tuesday at Scott Trade Center. David Backes connecting the dots with Berglund. Off the interchange, Schmidt takes him to the glass. Nate Schmidt comes away with a biscuit and roars through center. One hand on his stick, though. No worries there for Edmondson. Alex Pietrangelo sends it on around. Stastny with a lift check to spoil Wilson's advance. Brower goes 2-on-2. Pietrangelo out wide. Orlov puts a leg in there. Ooh. Ovechkin knocked down old friend Troy Brower.
And I think Brower knew that was coming, but tried to lay into him, and he ended up worse for wear on that one. Big OV knocked him right down with a clean hit in the corner.
7 minutes and change remaining in regulation time. Capitals hoping to ruin the shutout spell of the Blues on this trip as Richards' pass is deflected. Winnick will have to resurface through center. 29-27, Washington has the shots on goal advantage. Jake Allen has been awfully tough to solve in the Blues net. Shattenkirk plays it out there on the flank. Colton Parayko is next as Richards goes after him with an assist from Winnick. The long clear all the way down. It's icing against the Blues. Hadid shows us the road ahead, and there is a suitcase in my future.
Not till after Monday, buddy. Monday, the Blue Jackets come to town. John Tortorella's club. We'll have all the action right here at 7 o'clock on CSN. We're at the Flyers, at the Avs, at the Coyotes, and finishing up the five games against the Islanders.
Boone Jenner has a goal today, locker for Columbus. Losing to Nashville and Music City at the moment. James Neal on the board for the Preds. Schmidt in tandem with Carlson with 6:25 remaining in the third period. Nate Schmidt bounced that one off of Ryan Reeves. Ovechkin waiting on the boards. Bortuzzo with a step up. Alex Ovechkin again hit by Bortuzzo. Williams goes one-on-one, fires. That's deflected away by Lindbom. And we hear the whistle as we send it ringside to Al Kokin.
You know, Joe, I was curious to see if Barry Trotz would do any line juggling with the Capitals trailing by three, and he hasn't. But what has caught my eye is a few shifts in this third period that has reunited Brooks Orpik and John Carlson. And I think, guys, that is a question mark as the Capitals get closer to the playoffs. Will they reunite those two or kind of keep things spread out? Maybe we're getting a little foreshadowing of what's to come this evening.
Barry Trotz takes a lot of advice from Todd Reirden, Al, in those situations as to when to change pairings as Kuznetsov goes right off the draw for a pad save. That's just how sharp Jake Allen has been. Kuznetsov moves it along to Carl Alsner with a puck on the attack and time wasted in the third period. Kuznetsov, wonderful pass. Johansson sent it wide. Kuznetsov spins off the boards, protecting the puck away from Laterra. Kuznetsov darting behind, sweeps to the front, loose there. Burakovsky was tied up with Laterra. Good defensive work by the Blues center as Tarasenko will clear.
That was a good matchup, Tarasenko against Kuznetsov, and he had the better of Tarasenko down low. Some pretty good stick work again, having a tough time getting second and third whacks at the puck in front of Allen.
Galiev, Chimera, and Beagle this trip for Barry Trotz. Just over 5 minutes left in this third period. Nothing after one. 3-0 for the Blues through two. They scored three goals on seven shots in an eight-minute span.
Well, coming into tonight's game, they were 8-2 the last 10 games overall. The hottest team when you look at numbers overall in the NHL.
Clinched a playoff berth out west last night. In a great run for a Central Division title.
Yeah, they need 11 of 14 points that remain on the table, including the two tonight, to get first spot.
Bortuzzo's not going to keep this one in. Delayed offside, washed out against St. Louis. 4:25 remaining. Orlov looking to Winnick. Matched up there with Lindbom. Winnick at his feet for a moment. Hard work from Troy Brower rescues the puck for the Blues. The double comes from Richards on the takeaway check. Winnick feeds Carlson, joining stick check there at the last instant before the blue liner could pull the trigger. Fabry goes one-on-one. Fabry going to the outside on Wilson, a snapshot that goes high. Winnick turning back, greeted there by two Blues as the Caps are changing. So too St. Louis.
29 shots in the second period. Things have tightened up here in the third, Joe. Just 10 shots combined between these two hockey clubs.
Williams all the way to the corner with Edmondson. There's Backstrom, tracked down by Pietrangelo. Ovechkin gets into the act. Berglund will leave it. And through center comes Brodziak on the move. He had the first goal today. He and Reeves spearheading the forecheck for the Blues. The Capitals with a smart-looking breakout. It's Niskanen on the run.
He had the first goal last night, too. That one was shorthanded.
The Backstrom wrister right into the glove of Jake Allen. Get you back for the final 3:05 in this third period. The Blues have been keeping tabs on the Grade 8. The salute is brought to you by Pentagon Federal Credit Union. This evening's honoree, Sergeant Justin Cullimer, an active member of the United States Army since 2013. Justin, thanks for all that service. We appreciate your dedication. The Capitals and the St. Louis Blues. Jake Allen has mastered Washington so far this evening, trying to become the third goalie this year to shut him out. Martin Jones, San Jose. Peter Mrazek, Detroit, the two to precede him. The Blues on a franchise record shutout roll. The first 3/4 of it provided by the net minding of Brian Elliott. Backus at center. Carlson will slug it out wide for Backstrom. Then Ovechkin tries the toe drag. Edmondson gets enough of him to take the puck away and clear.
Elliott, three shutouts, Joe. Our esteemed colleague Brent Johnson had three in a row. Also one of the few in the history of their franchise. He did it in the playoffs.
Orloff with a blast. It's blocked. A follow-up chance at knuckles wide. John Carlson walks it all the way to point position. Elias, Sports Bureau tells us that Elliott's the only active goalie to have three shutouts in a row three different times in his career.
That's pretty darn impressive.
Centering pass to the front, they score. Some window dressing provided by Patrick Berglund in a 4-0 lead.
And again, their defense was involved on this play, Joe. They turned the puck over and they took it up the ice. Pietrangelo, I think, threw that puck in front to Berglund. He's got his ninth goal. Here they are coming over the blue line. A little give and go back and forth. And there's the pass coming across. Stastny, Pietrangelo, Berglund. And it beats the blocker side of Grubauer. 4-0 with 2:15 to go here in Washington.
As Barry Trotz makes some notes, Patrick Berglund's ninth of the season. Five of his first eight were game winners for these Blues, who are about to bank points numbers 98 and 99. Burakovsky on the go. Andre, whoo, flattened there by a hard hit from Lindbom. Allen makes another save, up to 31. Philip Grubauer leaves for a turning Carl Alsman. Washington will lick their wounds and get ready for Columbus on Monday. These Blues hosting the Avalanche on Tuesday at Scott Trade Center. The Caps will have a chance to make amends on April 9th, one day prior to the regular season ending. Originally, that was the last game of the season, but the makeup with Anaheim on the 10th will follow. Niskanen for Chimera. Parayko with a strip. Parayko snapshot, a pad save for Grubauer. Four different goal scorers for the Blues in this impressive performance. Galiev sends it around. Beagle taps for Chimera. Jason comes to the point for a Schmidt-Rister. Knocked away by Brodziak.
Yeah, just can't get pucks through, whether it's at the top with the D or it's down low. Getting more opportunities against Allen has not been the job here tonight for the Caps. Been very difficult against a very disciplined and detailed Blues team.
This is about the fifth year in a row, Locker, where I see them in the regular season and I go, I'm not sure if I've seen a team any better.
I know. I agree with you.
As Richards walks in, rolls one to the front. That guy who just paddled the puck away was very important to St. Louis's success. Jake Allen, sharp tonight. The Blues just have not been able to get it done come springtime. This win will be their 45th. Washington sitting at 53 victories and 111 overall points. Their next point will be good to wrap up the best mark in the regular season. It'll have to wait until Monday at the earliest. Dallas a winner earlier today. As time ticks off, it's four shutouts in a row for the St. Louis Blues. 4-0, they down the Caps. Coach Hitchcock has to be very pleased with the guys wearing the blue notes. Our Caps player of the game tonight, sponsored by the Palm Restaurant, we select Stan Galiev.
I thought he played well, had some shots on net, played over 11 minutes, got some decent ice time, was patted on the back a couple of times by the coaching staff. I thought he had his legs and got a couple of quality chances tonight.
Friends, you can enter to be the Palm Fan of the Month at thepalm.com/fan. 32 saves for Jake Allen. Not bad. St. Louis, a winner, 4-0 in D.C. Caps postgame live, Sebastian Salazar and Alan May.